YouTubers. I gotta take these off all the time. I can't see a distance with these, but if I want to see up close, it's like every man over 40, which is actually coming to my birthday pretty soon. And the fucking fan's running again. It always runs in here. I don't know what it is. It's like I'm trying to keep them warm or something. And anyway, coming up to my birthday pretty soon. Nobody needs to know what that is. But nearing the end of my my life in the 40s. So, anyway, but to see, so any man over 40, woman too, you generally have to wear these cheater glasses, right? Your reading glasses. Oh, yeah, look how clear that is. Take them off. Just a fucking look. Anyway, what to do today? So today, I'm a little behind. So usually I will film on Monday. You guys know all this. I film on the Monday for the following Monday. So today I'm filming on the Sunday for tomorrow, Monday. Reason for that being, we're quite busy on the weekend. And then this past week, I was very busy with work. So we're away, Lake Superior area. Lutzen, as a matter of fact, a lot of you know that I love freaking skiing. So, I guess if I could snowmobile all the time here, which it's just not worked out in the last 3 years or so, I would. But skiing is my, I don't know, skiing almost surpasses snowmobiling now as my number one favorite thing to do, downhill skiing. So, yeah. Man, I wish I could go again. I'm kind of sad that it's over for the year. So the snow's gone here. There's little skiffs of snow, you know, here and there along the bush lines. But ski hills are closed now around here. So if I wanted to go skiing again, I pretty much got to go west. And I'm not totally ruling that out because skiing out in the mountains will run till about June, actually. End of May, June, depending on the warm weather and, you know, if it gets cold. I don't think they make snow anymore out there in the mountains. You know, it just gets to be that the daily highs just get to be so high, and then you have to have a certain temperature to be able to make snow anyway. So, anyway, gonna do something quick today. Well, what's not quick, right? My videos are usually, I'll work like an hour. Anywhere, I say hour, hour and a half. Sometimes I'll stretch it to 2 hours if something's causing some trouble, but it's going to be real quick today. This will definitely not take me more than an hour today. So, picked out a few. You've seen these before. You've seen me use these in making videos before. There's rail spikes. Rail spikes. Where do I get them? Well, you don't get them at the grocery store. You get them in a place where you would find spikes just hanging out, just laying around, you know? I'm not going to say where I get spikes, but the places where I can get spikes, I could probably walk 200 feet and pick up just as many spikes, just laying off, you know, in the ditches, things like that. So they get discarded. You know, I think when they change rail or they change ties or rail plates like that, I think they just change them out automatically and then they just toss and just kind of discard them. So anyway, I kind of just go pick them up wherever I find them. Does that mean I picked them up along the rail somewhere? No, I'm not saying that. I guess it kind of gets inferred though, huh? Anyway, got spikes, lots of spikes. Oh, I can't really move them this way. Anyway. I got some spikes, and I got this board. So now they're making, wow, is it ever light? So that's rough sawn, not really rough, heavily rough sawn, but I would say it's rough sawn, gray washed board. And would that be 1 inch? I'm going to think it's 1 inch. Yep, 1 inch. 1 inch board. What can you make with 4 spikes, or as many spikes as you want, and rough sawn gray board, which, like I say, it's meant to look like, I think, barn board or distressed board. We could distress it more and beat the shit out of it with a hammer, but should we? Yeah, why not? Let's beat the shit out of it with a hammer. Okay, let's get this video going long enough. Hey, here's some good news for you guys. So I'm nearing up on 300 subscribers. And when I hit 300 subscribers, which should not be long from now, hopefully, I'll do a giveaway. I'm not going to tell you what the giveaway is. It's not going to be anything really heavy because to ship stuff from Canada is flipping insane. I just sent two things to a couple friends of mine in the States, and I made sure I did it when I was in the States just recently, like I say, down along Lake Superior, Minnesota, right by Wisconsin, Minnesota border there, Lake Superior. And it was cheap. It was almost like free. And the woman gave me the boxes to pack the stuff. For the one thing to send, I actually priced it up to what send one of the items that I did send the other day. It was $47 to send one thing from Canada here. Now that's crazy. I'm not doing that. I would never do that. So down in the States, that same thing was $7. So I don't know what we got going on with Canada Post, but you know, you can barely send anything in your own country here without it costing an arm and a nut. So I don't know. Funny thing is, even rail service in Canada is extremely expensive. You can't get anywhere. You got Amtrak down in the States, you guys down in the States. It's the most affordable means of transportation that you can ever come up with. I would go down and visit my sister and take Amtrak from Grand Forks to Milwaukee or just outside Columbus. And it would be quite often like $70. It's crazy, you know. And it's a sleeping, anyway, that's a longer story. Sleeping trip and lots of room. I'll do a product demo on another video, but I picked up these auto locking sliders I've been trying to get for a long time here in Canada. You can't seem to get them here without paying, again, tons and tons of money. But here, I'll show you the smaller ones. So they're auto lockers. So you set your tension right here, a little adjustment nut. And let's see, you want to go with something this size. Okay, I'm locked on. Unlock. Now what? Want to go to something else? Hell, I don't know. Thinner, let's say, okay? Take a piece of scrap. You see that? Same tension. Thin, thick, doesn't matter. This board. Locked on. Same thing. Tell me that ain't handy. You know, when you're fiddling around with the screw, with the jaw distance screw, that's a pain in the ass. You're trying to hold something, and all of a sudden it's not good enough, and you're kind of messing around with it, and that doesn't work. Anyway, these are great. I've been looking for these for a long time. They're made by C.H. Hansen. Down in the States, $9. Here in Canada, if you wanted to get these same pliers, $65. Anyway, I'll do a review on these in another video. So don't forget, doing the giveaway at 300 subs. And I'll, even when that's going to come up, I'll do a little video for that and show you what we're going to give away. And anyway, all that said, let's get cracking. Notch them, bend them, fill them with weld, grind them, and that's it. It makes it a little easier, anyway. There you go, all the same angle. Basically all the same. You don't need carbon copies of each other. They just need to be fairly close. Yeah, we'll clean up our ends. weld our other ends. Let's do that. Coat hooks. Now the spacing. Yeah, probably want to start out 4 inches from the end anyway, I imagine. So we stayed there 4 inches from the end. And then every what?
Four for sure.
Hey YouTubers, Herman's here. In case you hear this weird voice in the background. That's okay, Herman. Go ahead, you can talk to the people. They're not afraid of you. Let's see. No, that's 4. Went 8. 8 didn't look bad, but that doesn't look enough yet. 10 inches maybe? That gives you a good sized jacket. Herman, talk.
I'm
over.
12.
12?
Probably 12 inches.
It's quite a bit of room between jackets, you think so?
Yeah, but if you put a jacket here, it's coming here, then you put another jacket here. It'll be touching for sure.
4 inch off the end. So that's 4 inch off the end, up there, 4 inch, and 12 inch, he says. Herman says 12s. Herman says 12, something like that, like that. It's kind of interesting, none of these are actually identical. Hey Herm, look at them. I didn't really polish them up super well because I didn't want the board to be. I said I was going to beat the piss out of this board yet with a hammer. I told him earlier, so I got to beat this board with a hammer yet, roughen it up a bit. So we'll do that here. Anyway, so still 12 inch on center. That won't be bad, I think.
It'd be too short.
Too short for what?
Well, too short if you want to make full length.
Well, what if I use a saw? If I use a saw, would it be too short then?
No, if you cut it 3 inches, you'd be any short.
Herman is always throwing a fucking monkey wrench into every fucking plan I have for some reason. I don't know why. It's too short, it's too long, it's... Christ. So, your girlfriend was visiting with you all day, huh?
Well, she's not going to be around tomorrow. Going to Winnipeg, and I don't want to follow her.
No? You generally just chase behind the car like a dog run.
Well, she always wants me to go, so I said that. I don't want to go.
What do you think?
Looks good.
Looks like a plan?
Yeah, looks like a plan to me.
Okay, so let's take a pencil and we'll mark. Sort of, kind of. And then we'll just mark centers after I mark. This one. This is the silver one. Can you see that? Yeah. Let's mark these. You're not going to see it anymore. It's my new pencils I picked up for marking on steel. It says it's a silver streak. You see it? Welder's pencil. Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't know if it's any better than any other pencil. But... bought a couple. Let's see if it is or not. It's silver, so you can't really see it, can you? And I guess I better go 4 inches past this guy to make the saw cut. You guys can't see all the way over here, but that's okay. I'll show you later. That's done. 4 inch. Something like that. All right. So that's a true 1-inch board. but it's extremely light.
An oldie center.
Where do I want to put these? What do I want to line up? Maybe just line up the bottoms of the hooks. Just the bottoms here. What do you think, man? Maybe just line up with the bottoms.
To me?
Yeah, that one's a little bit shorter. Because they're not all exactly the same, these hooks. Or these hooks. These spikes. But I don't think it's far off. Herman, where'd you put my auto punch when you last had it?
I sold it.
YouTubers, that's an auto punch. In case you don't have any manual punches, that's an auto punch. Herman, you've seen these before, right?
Yep.
So we're going to drill our holes. If you just drill one, what happens if we drill one hole, Herman?
It'll turn.
If you put your heavy toque on here, it'll turn.
Yes.
Or your underwear. Your heavy underwear you never take off all winter long. So let's put one here and one here. So let's put two, right?
Sounds like a plan to me.
Sounds like a plan, Stan. Auto punch. I go like three times. It makes a little divot. You guys don't need to see that. It's the same as a punch. You know, if you had a punch... Let's pretend I had a punch. I had my punch there and I just struck my punch. Same idea. This is an auto punch. It's a little handier. What have we got on the back side here? That's not bad. Two. Come on. Two, not too far apart. So we go like that. Drill a hole the same size as our screw. On maximum speed. No, sorry, slow speed. Don't need it. Let's see, is that a masonry bit on there? No, it's on hammer drill though. Let's get this show going here. Properly. What are we doing? Amateur. Amateur hour. Alright, so we got that hole. Then, what I like to do is, because I don't want screws sticking up the top and hooking people's coats, take that screw, you get a bit that's slightly bigger than that screw head. See that screw head? Take that bit. And then just chamfer that hole a bit. What else do they call it? Just countersink, huh, Herm?
Yep.
Countersink or chamfer? Chamfer, the same thing?
Same thing.
What do I know? I just work here. See how that fits. Yeah, a little bit more. I like it to be flush fit. Yeah, that's not bad at all. But it ain't good enough yet. Much better. Good. Okay, guys. We'll shut you off and then we'll turn you back on when it's all done. What do you think, guys? There you go. Railroad spike coat hanger. See how we beat the piss out of it with a hammer? Herman was wincing in pain when I was doing it. He didn't like it, but now he wants me to paint it, and I'm not painting shit. So now we're going to hang it up. You see, that's how we countersink the... focus in, baby. That's how we countersink the screws, you see? Countersunk. Look at those fingers on that guy. You can tell he doesn't do much work.
That's right.
Pushes a lot of pencils and paper clips around.
Fucking all broken.
Anyway, guys, that's it. There's your Monday night video. Done on a Sunday. So, say goodnight, tubers.
Goodnight, tubers.